Welcome to Reality Creative Video. I'm Hermes, and today we're going to cover baking soda and food-grade washing soda. I'm going to show you the differences between the two. There may be some colloidals that need to be cooked at a high pH. Platinum is one of them. And so I'm going to show you how to prepare. So what's the difference between baking soda and washing soda? The difference between baking soda and washing soda is the pH. I have two beakers here filled with 50 milliliters of fluid of distilled water. And as you can see, the pH is around 7.5, 7.4. Actually, it should be a little lower than that, but I'm reusing these beakers. So they're both the same. And now we're going to mix a little bit of baking soda in here. Just a small amount. And then we're going to mix a little bit of washing soda in here. About the same amount. And we're going to mix these. I'm going to mix the baking soda up. I'm going to flip this around so we don't contaminate the other sample. And I'm going to mix this one around. And now we're going to put our meter in here. All right, this is the baking soda one, and it is going to a reading of at 8.4 pH. All right, now we're going to just rinse this off briefly in 7.2 pH water. And we're going to stick it in here in the washing soda one. And now, as you can see, the washing soda one is over 10.78, 79, 80, very close to 11 pH. That's the main difference between the two. The washing soda has a much higher pH than the baking soda. Now, in some of the things where you do in your experiments, you may require a higher pH, and baking soda will only going to get you, as you saw, up to 8.5. The washing soda will get you to nearly 11. And so you may need to use washing soda for some experiments. So I'm going to show you how to... Now, anything you consume needs to be food grade. So if you buy, you can buy washing soda online, food grade washing soda. Or you can make your own from baking soda. And I'm going to show you how to make washing soda from make washing soda out of baking soda in a minute. And I've done it both ways. And the store-bought washing soda and the one that you make yourself from baking soda has the same pH. And it's simple to do. Okay, let's make some washing soda from baking soda. So you're going to get a little pan like this. And you're going to get your toaster oven and your baking soda. And you're going to pour it in here like this. I'm just going to do a little bit because I don't need all that much. All right, but you're going to spread it out. Now, I'm going to spread it out like this on the tray. Now, what makes the difference between baking soda and washing soda is hydrogen. Baking soda's got hydrogen in it, and the hydrogen lowers the pH. So we are going to bake the baking soda. We're going to put it in here like this. And we're going to turn this thing on to bake. All right. And we're going to set the temperature to 400 degrees. And we're going to set the time to 30 minutes. And then we're going to press start. And in 30 minutes, your baking soda will now be washing soda. And you can confirm that by doing the little experiment I did just a few minutes ago, putting a 16th of a teaspoon in 50 milliliters of water, mixing it up, and dropping your pH meter in there. And you should get a rating of 10.75 or even higher. If you don't, then bake it again for another 30 minutes. I've only had to bake it once, and I got a reading of 10.75, so you shouldn't have to do it more than once either, as long as you follow the parameters here. Well, that's it. I'm Hermes. This is Reality Creative Video, and I will talk to you again soon.